Hi, Carrie here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. Do you have the situation where you send an invoice out to somebody and they tell you they're going to make multiple payments on that invoice? Perhaps it's a large one, maybe there's cash flow, whatever, and you agree to that. But then these amounts come in on the bank feed and you don't quite know how to match them to that invoice. And one of you wonderful YouTube viewers sent me a question asking how we resolve that. And that's what we're going to do today.
In this example, I've created an invoice for a fake customer here for an amount of $15,000. And I'm going to say that I'm allowing this particular customer to make three payments of $5,000 each to me. So I've got this invoice and here we have the bank feed. So let's pop over to here and I can see that these amounts have come through, but of course they're not matching because the invoice is for $15,000. So I'm gonna pop here and I'm gonna select the very first one and I'm gonna say find a match. Now, one of the options that comes up is this invoice of $15,000. So I'm going to put a check mark here and I'm going to apply $5,000 to this particular invoice and save. So now if I checked the customer, actually, let's just do that. We'll have a look at that. Hold on. We can see here the invoice for $15,000 with the payment applied of only $5,000. And we've got $10,600 owing because there are another couple of invoices that have not been paid for. But the $10,000 relates to this $15,000 invoice. So we'll pop back to the bank feed. We'll scroll down here and we'll grab this next one. And we'll click find a match. And we will apply it once again to this invoice and click save. And then when we come to look at the bank feed, the bank feed's automatically suggesting a match for the balance of that invoice. So if you have a situation where people are paying you smaller amounts against an invoice, you can still use the matching from the bank feed, but you just have to click find the match and apply that against the invoice. So if we click match here, and if we pop back to our customer and refresh that page, we can see that only that $600 is owing now.
So hopefully that helps. If you have any other questions about working with the bank feed, do check out my website. I've got some courses, some free downloads. There should be some free downloads in the comments below as well. And if this was useful, do click like, subscribe to my channel. I hope to see you again soon. Cheers.